Okay, so I'm going to show you how easy it is to take stem cuttings, aka shoot cuttings, and how to avoid the common mistakes. Dirty equipment, too much light, too much heat, and inadequate moisture and humidity. Take a clean disposable scalpel or knife, the sharper the better. Next, choose a mother plant, well-watered, at least 2 months old, healthy and growing, not flowering or fruiting, fed adequately but certainly not over-fertilized. Find a shoot. The lower third of the plant is better because these shoots contain more natural rooting hormones. Slice through the stem beneath the shoot. Just below an internode is best, rather than in the center between internodes, although vigorous tomatoes like this are a lot more forgiving. Work fast, switch off any oscillating fans, take cuttings in small batches. Keep the propagator lid closed whenever possible to safeguard your existing cuttings, and prepare each cutting by removing any lower leaf or branches to give you an inch or so of bare stem to insert into your rooting media. If your chosen species is tricky to root, consider using a rooting hormone product, typically a liquid, powder, or gel. I'll talk more about these in a follow-up video. Now, dispense what you need and dip into that. Don't contaminate the actual product. Rooting media. Prepare all this ahead of time. Pre-soak Grodan AOK starter plugs for 15 seconds or so in tepid water, pH adjusted to 5.5. I tend to use about 80% reverse osmosis water and 20% tap water, along with a few drops of rapid start. Now these days, I don't add any nutrients at this stage because it mitigates the risks of salts concentrating in the starter blocks should they dry out. Use the smart trays, also by Grodan, as they raise the blocks up a little so they don't need to sit in puddles at the bottom of your propagator. That said, a little water in the tray really can help to boost humidity levels. So this is important for freshly taken cuttings to survive with no effective root system. Some growers miss the leaves one or two times a day. This helps to reduce transpirational stress and increase humidity. Rapid rooters are another great option. They come pre-moistened, but depending on how long they've been laying around, I sometimes re-moisten them with a little water and rapid start. Shoot for moist, but not sodden wet. Don't cram too many cuttings into one propagator or you risk mold issues. I remove the largest fan leaves entirely with my scalpel. Some growers cut half the leaves like this, but you must use sterilized scissors. All your equipment, including work surfaces, propagator, trays, and lids, should be as clean as possible. Now, cuttings don't have to be taken at 45 degrees. Just wop them off cleanly with minimal tissue damage. It's easier to insert them into the rooting media without bending or bruising or crushing the stem when cut like this. The cutting should always feel well anchored in the media. If you're cloning woodier species, use your scalpel to carefully scrape off the outer layer and use a rooting hormone product liberally. A single 2-foot T5 lamp above the propagator is ideal. I really like this lid from the Super Spreader kit because it's specially molded to accommodate it. Note how the lamp itself sits just above the plastic lid. Nice. I keep it on for 24 hours a day to promote stable temperatures in the low to mid 70s for temperate species like tomato. Higher temperatures or intense light stress your unrooted cuttings. Sitting a propagator at the periphery of your bedroom is probably sufficient in itself. Anything up to 90 micromoles of light intensity should be fine. The sweet spot for me seems to be around 60 to 75 micromoles. Some growers heat from the bottom with a heat mat, but be sure to connect it to a thermostat and set it to 72 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Turn it down or completely off once the roots have formed. Use a min-max thermometer with remote sensor inside the propagator so you can dial things in. And when you're done, put the propagator lid back on and close the vents. The propagator should mist up. That's a good sign. High humidity. Just what we want. For the first 5 days, all you'll probably do each day is lift the lid, feel that the media is still moist, and then put the lid back on. Now, some species root in 5 days, some can take months. Remove any cuttings that have wilted or show signs of dieback. Dying cuttings produce a musty, unpleasant odor, so don't forget to use your nose, too. Once a cutting produces roots, the moisture levels in the propagation media will deplete very quickly. Don't get caught out at just the point of success. Start to open the vents on your propagator lid. When media feels noticeably drier, prepare a dip solution with a vegetative-based nutrient formulation around 1.0 millisiemens or 500 parts per million at a pH of around 6. Dip the starter blocks and then put them back in the propagator. Try leaving the lid slightly off like this to gradually harden them up. When you see a bunch of roots shooting out of the bottom of the media, it's finally time to take them out of the propagator and transplant them to nursery pots. Something like Mother Earth CocoCoir plus Perlite Mix or CocoTech PX would be ideal. I always inoculate with mycorrhizae fungi at this stage. Don't put your freshly transplanted cuttings directly under your grow light, people. Give them a day or so to adjust just on the side of the bed first. A light mist with a seaweed solution will be well received at this point too. Final point, always take 50% more cuttings than you need. This isn't to balance out anticipated failure. Rather, it's to allow you to choose the very best ones for onward development. You can always give a surplus to deserving friends. Okay, 101 over. There's so much more to say, and if you're interested in this topic, tell me and we'll focus on advanced techniques for optimization and delve deeper into the science of cloning together. I look forward to hearing your tips too. Thanks for listening. This is Everest's clone slave saying goodbye.